can just sleep during my lecture, and when you wake up, you can watch the recording. Okay, okay, but I hope that you don't sleep. So, yeah, let's start with our lecture today. What are we going to study anyway? We're going to study something which is very interesting, namely about the movement of bodies, about scheduling for the planes, transportation, and so on. And as for your information, I lived for like 15 years in Europe because when I was a child, I went with my family to Germany for 7 years. And after that, I took my doctorate degree in Austria for 4 years. So it's like 12 years in Europe. And what I see in particular in Germany and in Austria is that the schedule, the transportation schedule is very precise. Yeah, not like in Indonesia. I don't know in Malaysia, but in Indonesia, sometimes the time is not always not always correct. Yeah, for example, if you say the train will come at 7:30, maybe sometimes 7:35 or 7:40 and something else. So this is actually not so good if we want to make for a big city like Jakarta or Bogor, where we have to be on time. Yeah, and therefore by studying kinematics, we can understand better how to schedule, and for example, how to plan your trip. If for example you want to go to the campus, you can predict how fast you are, and you can, for example, predict what is the correct time to arrive at the classroom on time. Yeah. So, but now we are on Zoom. This means that there are many what we call many advantage actually, because you don't have to go far, and you don't even have to take bath, and you don't even have to show yourself. Yeah. So I don't know even if you are in front of the screen, or if you are, for example, enjoying a movie or something like that, or playing games behind the screen. I don't know, but you know, actually, I just can trust you that you are following my lecture. Yeah. So whatever. Yeah. It's interesting to see how physics can affect our daily life. Yeah. For example, last week we already studied that physics is about something that we can measure. Something that we can measure is, for example, the position of a car, the speed of a car, the time flow, and so on, things like that. Your weight, your height. Yeah. Even we can measure your temperature, the brightness of a star. Yeah, so this kind of things is important if you want to agree upon something. Because there are some other things like, for example, feelings, yeah, or emotions, yeah, which cannot be expressed universally in agree measurement. Yeah. So yeah, this, yeah, yes, a very nice background. Yeah. Okay, let's make this lecture fun. If you have some comic background, please put it on and put on your video. Yeah, so in physics lecture, let's put on like Family Guy or something that you like. Yeah, your favorite comics, and put them on the screen. Yeah, so that physics is not scary. Yeah. Okay. Where were I? Yeah. So things that we can measure belongs to physics. Yeah. Especially natural phenomena such as your and also if, for example, things that you cannot measure like feelings or psychology or astrology, not astronomy but astrology, which we cannot agree universally, this belong to meta science or pseudo physics. So for example, there are many no products, yeah, like you wear like what we call healing talisman, yeah, jimat or something like that, yeah, like magnetic things you put on your body and you say you feel better after this. These are pseudoscience because you cannot really measure the effect. Yeah, you just feel, oh, I feel better after wearing this. Yeah, it's like just when you drink water and you give some, for example, some suggestion, it can affect your psychology. So you can start to believe. Yeah, you can start to believe that it is working. But actually, this is something called suggestion effect. Yeah, it's also placebo effect. Yeah, this is sometimes not physics. Yeah. So okay. Ah, okay. Welcome, students. Yeah, it's very nice to see that you have this background. Okay. Is it from Snoopy? Well, I don't know. Okay. Okay. Well, let's just start. Yeah. Share the screen and share the lecture for today. Sorry. Let's download, yeah, download our lecture first. Okay. This side cannot be reached. Let's go. Okay. So students, can you look at the screen and see the presentation?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Okay. So we study kinematics today, yeah, the science of movement. Maybe you can see that kinematics is something related to movement, displacement, velocity. Also, it has connection with sport, especially like athletics or sometimes cycling and something that we really have to measure in hundreds of seconds. Yeah, this kind of precision is required, for example, in Olympics. Yeah, and for example, yeah, can you spot the kinematic parameters? So what are the kinematic parameters? Maybe you can give me some hints. Yeah, like position. Yeah, this is the distance. And we have also position, which is a factor. We have the velocity. We have also the speed. Yeah. Okay. I don't know. I forget which one is factor, which is the scalar. Yeah. But there is a factor, and there is also a scalar. We have acceleration. Yeah. Which is also a factor. So a factor is a quantity that also has magnitude and direction. Yeah. For example, the velocity. The velocity from A to B. It is important to understand not only the magnitude, 5 meters per second, for example, but also the direction. Yeah, because when you go to a place, you also have to move in certain direction. Yeah, so this is important. Also, time. Yeah, this is also a parameter. Okay. So we have this kind of kinematics parameter. Of course, we also have the mass, the force, yeah. But at this moment, because we study kinematics, we don't care about the mass at this moment, and we don't care about the force, because this is something called dynamics. Yeah, dynamics is something related to the cause of the movement. Yeah, it's related to the cause. What is the cause of movement? Yeah, what is the cause of movement? This is our next week's topic. Yeah, the cause of movement. At this moment, we only concern about the movement itself. We only concern about the movement itself. We don't concern the cause of movement at this time. So we only care about position, displacement, velocity, speed, acceleration, and time. Yeah, at this moment. So this is a good question. How to avoid plane crashes? Yeah. So to avoid plane crashes, yeah, you have to understand the trajectory or the movement of the plane. Yeah. For example, you have plane A moving this direction, plane B moving in this direction. Yeah, this is plane B moving in this direction. So there is a danger that they will intersect here. Yeah, they will produce a collision at this point. So to avoid collision, you have to calculate at certain time, at another time, where will be the position of the plane. And this is conducted by the computers. There is something called the ATC, I think, yeah? ATC. Some of you know what is the abbreviation of ATC? Okay, some of you can give me hint what is the abbreviation of ATC? Air?
Traffic control.
Yes, this is air traffic control. And air traffic control has the duty to avoid the planes of being running into each of the trajectories or paths. So no plane can intersect each other. And if they intersect, then they must have different height. Yeah. For example, when you go to a plane and the plane suddenly go up. Yeah. The plane suddenly go up. Yeah. This is an indication that maybe another plane is moving here. So the plane must go to a different height, yeah, must go to a different height so that it doesn't collide with the plane. So the ATC's duty is to avoid plane crash in the air. And this is application of kinematics, yeah, one application of kinematics. Okay. Yes, very interesting. Let's go. Yeah. To the next. I have only a black screen. Yeah. How do you spot the kinematic parameters? Yeah. Can you spot the kinematic parameters? Yeah. What are the kinematic parameters? It's easy. Yeah. The position, velocity, acceleration, maybe something, height. Yeah, and time. Okay, so actually the main, yeah, height can be assumed also as position. So at the end we only have four important parameters, yeah, position x, velocity v, acceleration a, and time is t. These are the main parameter in kinematics. Yeah. Okay, it is also important to understand that the formula for kinematics can also be applied to social or even healthcare or even other fields. Yeah, this is because, for example, when you have a formula, you have the same type of growth, the same type of analogy with other cases. Yeah. For example, you know maybe from high school, this formula. Where is my drawer? Yeah, this one. For example, V is equal to, the position, yeah. The position is equal to the velocity times the time. This is the most basic equation for constant velocity. Yeah, this equation can also be modeled, for example, to understand the growth of your tree or your plants. Yeah, the growth of your tree can be modeled as, for example, V now is the rate of growth, let's say the rate of growth over time. For example, grows height 3 centimeter per day. Can you guess after 5 days how much height has it now? When the previous height is, for example, 10 centimeters, then after 5 days, how much does it increase? Then just plus, with this formula, plus 5 times 3 is 15 centimeters. So at after 5 days, the height of the tree is 25 centimeters. Yeah, this is the analogy, for example. Or you have, for example, the growth of a population. The total population is, let's say, increase in population growth times the time. Yeah, so for constant growth, we can use this formula. What if we have acceleration? If we have acceleration, maybe you understand the formula is, yeah, you know this formula, right? Yeah, this is the formula for constant acceleration. And this formula can also be used to predict, for example, cases of virus. Yeah, the virus was first identified around November in Wuhan. This coronavirus first occurred in 2019, actually, during November. You see, it is just detected more seriously December, and worldwide effect on January. So, using this formula, we can even predict, yeah, or model the amount of increase in COVID cases. Yeah. So, this shows that many benefits can be obtained by studying the laws of kinematics, not only in physics, but also in other fields. Even in economy, the law of kinematics can be used to, for example, predict the amount of interest, yeah, interest in your deposit or in your money. Yeah, so we can use the law of kinematics to many things as long as there is growth, acceleration, and so on. Okay, so this is the application of kinematics. Yeah, as I said, this is the amount of activity in the sky. There are hundreds of planes operating every day. And this is an important task to ensure that no plane will cross each other because the danger of plane collision. Yeah. So this is one of the applications of kinematics to avoid, for example, when two planes are going to crash each other, there will be an alarm and the ATC will warn the pilots. Yeah. Please increase your height or please change your route. Yeah. Please change your routes. So at the end, they will avoid each other. Yeah. By the way, there is a story about three people. Yeah. Four people in a plane. First, there is the pilot, and then there is the very rich guy. Let's say he is a conglomerate. Yeah. And we have an IPB student. And we have like a monk, yeah, or we say Pak Ustad, yeah. And when they were flying, you see, when we were flying, suddenly there is high turbulence, yeah. And then the people get afraid. And after that, suddenly the machines of the plane stop working, yeah, error. And you see, there is panic. Yeah? There is panic all over the plane. Yeah? So people are getting very afraid. And the pilot says like this, dear passengers, because of this situation, I have to inform you that our plane will crash. And then I'll get panicked and say, don't panic. We have enough. We have parachutes. We are four people, but we have only three parachutes. And suddenly all of the people get more panic because there is only three parachutes, but there are four people. So the pilot says like this. And usually the pilot is a gentleman, right? But this is a strange pilot. He said like this, because I am the pilot, I have to take safety and report this to my company. For the sake of science, I have to inform what causes this machine failure. So I take one parachute and then you decide you have three people, you are you have two parasites left. You decide who will be saved and who will sadly be killed. Yeah. So the pilot takes this parachute and he jumps from the plane. So this is a plane without any pilots. Yeah. So there is an IPB student. Yeah. Okay. There is the monk and there is the very rich person. Yeah. And then the very rich person says, I am the CEO of a company of 1,000 people. I have to save my my labors, yeah, my working people there. Without me, the company will also crash. So he take one and he go outside. Yeah. So there is only one parachute left. There is the monk and there is the EPP student. Yeah. And you can guess what is the next story. Yeah. So the monk says to the EPP student, yeah, you have a bright future. Yeah, because you are a student of Pak Hendradi, you are a physics student. Yeah. So please take your I am also already close to God. I maybe the time has come, I'm old. Yeah. The IPB student is a very clever student. Yeah. And say, don't worry. Yeah, don't worry, sir. Yeah, you will be, both of us will be safe. Then the monk is feel very confused. Why? There is only one parachute. Don't worry, said the IPB student. I already changed my bag, yeah, with the parachute. So the rich people, the businessman is taking my bag instead of the parachute. Yeah. So you know what I mean? The person that just jumped, the rich people, he took the IPB student bag for lecture, yeah, not for parachute. So this means that there are still two parachutes left. Okay, so both of them are safe. And the unlucky person is the rich business person. Okay. Okay. So what is this story connected with our lecture today? Well, actually, there is no connection between the joke and the lecture. So I just want to make you laugh. Okay. So why should I be so serious? Because this is physics lecture. Yeah. The only connection is that don't be so greedy person. Yeah. Okay. Okay. And suddenly, when they want to jump, then the machine go on again. Okay. So, okay. And the pilot just say, oh my God, I should be on the plane. Because the machine is turning on again. So what am I doing? Okay. Yeah. So everybody is happy unless the rich person. I have nothing against a rich person. It's just a funny story that I want to share to you. Okay. So some of my students criticize me when I give lecture. Why you always give so many jokes? Yeah, I say because physics is already difficult. So I make the life more easy by giving jokes. So they don't have to do the formulas. Yeah. So okay. Yeah. So actually, ambition is become a comic. Standing in front of you and make jokes and you laugh, but sometimes my student only laugh when I fall from the podium or maybe when my mic is falling down or when I slip into the ground. Sometimes they laugh, but when I give some jokes, they don't laugh. Maybe because they are millennials. Yeah, you are millennials, so you understand better than me. Yeah, you understand better than me about jokes. Yeah, or actually, you are afraid of me, but I don't be afraid. Okay. So, okay, I hope that the jokes is giving you some, okay, I have some, if you have question, you can give. Okay, so your question is giving the funny face. I don't know what this means, but okay. Yeah, so the best question is, yeah, actually the best question is as follows, yeah. The best question is when, if, maybe you can read in your chat. Yeah? The best question is, when will be the lecture? When is the lecture finished? So because, okay. Yeah. So let's go back to the topic. So what is kinematics? Yeah. There is an important analogy between kinematics and cinema. Yeah. Maybe you heard about this cinema. Yeah. What is cinema actually? Cinema is motion picture, right? Motion picture like Walt Disney, like Donald Ducks, yeah, something like that, yeah. This is cinema, motion picture. So kine is something related to motion, yeah. Nah, kinematics is the study of motion. Without paying attention to Pak Dodi, no. Without paying attention to the cause, yeah. To the cause of the motion of the object. Okay, so we deal with the question how an object moves. We observe the change of motion and so on. Yeah. So these are the parameters in kinematic distance, displacement, speed, velocity, acceleration, or movement. Yeah. This deceleration is the negative of acceleration. Okay. So this is one of the application that you often use. Google. What is this? Google Map. Yeah. I'm sure that many of you use Google Map. Google Map for what? For understanding, yeah, where is my food delivery now? Yeah. Where is Pak Gojek? Where is Pak Grab? You already arrived or you arrive at different point. Okay. So actually, yeah, we always use kinematics every day. So why do we hate something that we use every day? Yeah. For example, yeah, if you like a person, you want to meet him every day. If you like to order food, you want to have Google Map every day. So Google Map is application of physics. So there is no reason to hate physics. Yeah. When I was a student, actually, I never hate physics. I only hate physics teachers. Yeah, because when I make mistake, she always, you know, what is the English word of cewek? Actually, they always pull my ears. Yeah. When I get a bad mark, she pull my ears. So I don't hate physics, but I hate the person. So please don't hate physics. Yeah. But hate the person that teach physics. Yeah. No, I just wanna make sure that you don't hate physics. Yeah. Don't hate me, please. Okay. Yeah. So, yeah. Where are you? Yeah, this application that we use Google Map is actually working because we use satellites. Yeah, we have satellites above the sky. Yeah, satellites above the sky, whose the duty of the satellite is actually to give us the correct information. Yeah, if we this is the Earth. There are actually three satellites that is required to give you the correct information. Why? Because we live in a three-dimensional Earth, yeah. So we have to be precise, yeah. Using three satellites, we have this called triangulation. Triangulation is a process of finding the correct position using three satellites, yeah. So there, each satellite send a line, and the line that intersects both of the three satellites, all the three satellites, the line that intersects, yeah, berpotongan, this is the correct position. And the precision of current GPS is less than 2 meters now. Yeah, it's less than 2 meters. This is important because if we don't have a precision like this, then it is possible that when you order food, your neighbor will be very thankful to you. Yeah, you know why? Because the delivery goes to your neighbor, not to you. Yeah, you order, for example, steak, yeah, or very delicious food, and your neighbor say thank you for your compliments. Yeah, because of the GPS problem. But we have very good triangulation nowadays, and in the future, what will happen? You sit in a car, you just sit in a car, and then there will be a voice like saying. For example, hello John, where will you go today? And you just answer, hello, I wanna go to, for example, I wanna go to the physics lecture. Yeah, this is very, very strange because usually we wanna go somewhere else. Yeah, I wanna go to the physics lecture. So and then okay, where is the position? And then you just say it IPB University. and then the car will move by itself to application. You don't have to do anything because it's of the car already have this kind of air traffic control, let's say like the ATC, and you just sit in your car, you don't have to drive, and the car will then bring you to the location without you have to drive or anyone has to drive. So everyone will have their own driver from the GPS. Yeah, and this is something that is not just dreaming, because maybe in 5 or 6 years, this will be reality. Yeah, and then you will just enjoy going somewhere without even driving. Yeah? I'm not joking, this is going to be a realization. So if your generation will be very, very lucky, because for example, you have this fiber optic speed. Yeah. You can download like 2 terabytes per second. Can understand? 2 terabytes per second is you can download hundreds of Korean movie in just 5 minutes. Yeah, this is very dangerous, because then you just watch Korean movie and you don't watch physical lecture. And another application is, like I said before, you just order without any driver. So when you order food, your food will be delivered by drones and robots, yeah, not by human. So this means that your food will be delivered automatically. Yeah, this is all going to be happening. My English. This is all going to happen in the future. Yeah. So, please understand that what you learn today will be applied in a very sophisticated way in the future. So physics is not just about calculating formulas, yeah, but more about how you can have better life with is all this kind of we have one chat, yeah, with all these kinds of pinch. What is pinch? Okay, what is pinch? Okay. Okay, understand. Okay. So, any question? Yeah, please. If you have enough quota, turn on the video so that I can we can see each other. Yeah, there are where are there more gentlemen beside me that wants to appear on the screen. Okay, please brag about your background. Yeah. Give a very funny background so all of us can laugh, yeah, so we can all forget about the lecture. Yes, this is triangulation, yeah, application of GPS. Yeah. Some people say why do you teach physics with jokes, don't be too serious. Yeah, I think we have you know, my best students always have this kind of humor, and they like to think freely. And one of the things you have to learn is that when you have to study something, the first thing you have to do is to like, yeah, you have to like the subject. It is not important that you can remember the formula. It is important that you like the subject, because when you like something, you are invincible. Yeah? You are, for example, you are unstoppable. You will be successful if you like something. I remember the story about a woman golfer who is very young. Yeah, she is from a Chinese descent, and she first appeared in the Women Master Series when she is only 14 years old. And all the journalists asked, Why are you playing so well? Why are you so good? What is the secret behind it? She just says, I'm just naturally, I really like golf because it's fun. So the secret is to be very good at the subject. As in, you have to find that this subject is fun for you or interesting. Yeah, because all the theories, all the things that you can read without having to listen to me, just read the slides. The first thing is you have to like your subject. Yeah. This is why every lecture, please change the background, something that is fun to you. Okay. Yeah. So this is the important thing that you have to remember. When you work on a subject, when you do something, then you have to like the subject, because otherwise you will be stressful. Okay. Hello, Firdaus. I like your background. It reminds me about my future. Ya, Firdaus ya?
Ya.
It reminds me of my future. Oke. Okay. Ya. Yeah. Thank you for your video. For the others, please express yourself. Express yourself and yeah. Rahmida, what's your background? Can you tell us?
Answer, it's from a famous meme.
Okay, is something that your favorite show or something?
I have no idea what it is.
Okay, it's something, but there is something burning behind. Yeah.
Yes.
Okay.
Exactly.
I have a story about this. You know, that at one point there is fire in a lab. There is a physicist and a mathematician and a chemist. You know. What is the chemist doing when the fire first occur? The chemist takes the water, of course, and the salt, and then he's put it into the fire, and the fire goes off because he's a chemist. He understands that to extinguish fire, he has to use something that is pressure the oxidation. Yeah, and the physicist is more creative. He put some soap or something around the fire, so he thinks that when the fire spreads out, the fire will be in the circle of this material that he gives, and it will extinguish. Yeah, but the best of them is the mathematician. You know why? Because the mathematician, he didn't do anything. He just put out a paper and just write and do some calculation, and then he suddenly left the room, and all of the two are amazed. Are you crazy, John? Yeah. Are you crazy, John? Why are you doing this? Say, don't worry. I have calculated that the fire will die with itself. Yeah. You just leave the room and the fire will die by itself. And they are so amazed. So it's good to have a mathematician. Yeah. And then suddenly they realize after they left the building that the mathematician did some miscalculation. Do you know what I mean? When they leave the building because they trust in the mathematician, they found out the mathematician makes some calculation, error in the calculation. Because of this error, the prediction that the fire will extinguish itself is not correct. You know what I mean? The fire will consume the building. Yeah? And then suddenly the mathematician cannot be found anywhere. Okay, it's not funny. Okay. It's not funny, so yeah. Okay. Yeah. Okay. So Firdaus, yeah. Can you give me your example about the application of kinematics? You're from Malaysia?
Yeah, yes, sir.
Yes. Okay, can you please give me some clue about the application outside the thing that I already give to you that you think that will benefit you in the future about kinematics? Just anything. It has nothing to do with physics, yeah. It can have to do with some other applications. But for example, okay. About the things that you give in the background, what is the application? Okay, let imagine that you are the manager of the cemetery. Okay, the manager of the cemetery. You have free space, right? You have free space. Yeah. I mean, some space that is not used for the cemetery at the moment. Okay. And then you can calculate what? For example, each day, how many people are dying? You know what I mean? How many places will be filled each day? So you have a parameter that gives you, for example, the average increase in the average rate in the occupation of your place. You know what I mean? So you can estimate, for example, what can you estimate? in the future. Using calculation, you can estimate when your cemetery will be full. Is it correct?
Yeah, correct. So
yeah,
and then I can estimate the population of the people surrounding the area.
Yeah, and then you can predict how much you have to expand for the next 2 years, let's say. Yeah. Otherwise, you have to put two people into one grave. This is not funny, right? Yeah. So what I mean is that there are so many applications that we sometimes don't aware of, right? But we can use this, and this is why I try to make you creative in thinking. Yeah, it's also so when you go after you pass this lecture, you will remember that creativity can, for example, give many solutions, right? Give many solutions. Okay. Yeah. So maybe others can give application of kinematics. Pravin Kumar, can you turn on your voice?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. But you are from Malaysia, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. So Kumar. Kumar, yes, or Pravin?
You can call me Pravin.
Pravin. Okay. Pravin, can you give me another example of kinematics? You are surprised, but just give one more example.
So is it about measuring the distance from a specific place to another specific place?
Yeah, right. For example, give me an example about what you do in the daily life that is connected to this what you just said. Like when you go to campus or when you go, for example, in another place. Can you just tell a story about this? Okay, where are you now? Where is your position now? In Malaysia?
Sorry, sir?
Are you in Bogor?
No, I'm in Malaysia.
You are in Malaysia?
Yeah.
Okay, good. What is your favorite place from your home?
I would say my friend's place.
Favorite place?
Yeah.
What? What's your favorite place? Swimming pool. Swimming pool or what?
Sorry, sir?
What is your favorite place from your home? Would you like to go there?
I think most probably my friend's place.
Okay, your friend's place. How do you reach your friend's place? How do you reach? By traveling with transportation, public transport, the car. Okay.
Yeah.
So, can you estimate the distance from your place to your friend's place? The distance, like how many kilometers?
It's around 10 kilometers.
10 kilometers, right? Yes. And based on your experience, how long will it take to go there? From your place to your friend's place.
3 minutes, 5 minutes.
Only 5 minutes. Only 5 minutes, 3 minutes. Okay. Yeah. 10 kilometer in 5 minutes. So you can estimate every minute how much you travel. At a rough estimation. Every minute how much you... 2 kilometer, right?
Yes.
Okay. 2 kilometer per second. 2 kilometer per minute, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. So in 1 hour, how many kilometer you will travel? Multiply by 30, right? Multiply by 60, right?
Yeah, 120, sir.
Sorry. Multiply by 30 because 2 kilometer per minute means 60 kilometer. Sorry. 2 kilometer per minute, 60 kilometer per hour. Is that correct? Or no? 2 kilometer per minute is 120 kilometer per hour, is that right? 120 kilometer per hour.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, that's crazy, right? I think your estimation is not correct because you drive a car less than 120 kilometer per hour.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah. Maybe the distance is not 10 kilometer. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, but I tell you that you can use your knowledge to estimate the distance, to estimate the distance. What is your average velocity using the car? you remember when you go to your friend's house? 60 kilometer per hour or
probably 60 and less than that.
60 kilometer per hour. And you say how many minutes do you take from your friend? 10 minutes or 5 minutes?
Yeah, around 5 minutes.
Okay. So 5 minutes means 5 minutes you arrive. So the distance is 5 minutes times you have 60 kilometer per hour. This is around 5 minutes is 1 to the 12th of an hour. Yeah? 1 to the 12th of an hour. So or you can change the 60 kilometer per hour into per minute. Yeah? How do you do that? How do you do this? You divide 60 with 60. So you have 1 kilometer per minute. Is it correct?
Yes, 60 sir.
Kilometer per hour is 1 kilometer per minute. So when you multiply 1 kilometer per minute with 5 minutes, how much is this? This is 5 kilometer, right? So I can estimate that the true distance between you and your friend is like 5 kilometer, not 10 kilometer.
Yeah.
Okay.
Most probably.
So most probably. What is the point behind this? The point behind this is that you can use physics to predict distance, right? Yeah. As you, what is the voice? Yeah. Okay. Okay. Is that correct?
Yep.
Okay. Thank you for your time. Okay. I will continue the lecture and not terrorize the student anymore. Yeah. So you have the distance in scalar unit. Yeah. For example, distance from Central Jakarta to IPB University is around 579 kilometer. Huh? Not possible. The distance from Central Jakarta to IPB University is maybe just, yeah. Who did this slide? I don't understand. I think 57.9 kilometer. There is a comma here. Okay, so it's 57,900 meter. Yeah, so there is a comma here. But you see, the distance is a scalar. The displacement is the shortest line. Yeah. So if you move in a circle, you will go back and the displacement is zero. Okay. So we have initial position and we have final position. The reference point is the point where you make the measurement. Yeah. For example, when the reference is here. Nice. Right. So the displacement is just the net or the difference between the initial and final position. Yeah, the final minus the initial position. So further, we have a motion of the object from x1 to x2. We start from here. Start from here, yeah. You move to this direction, yeah, and you meet, for example, a person here. So I'm not good at drawing, yeah. So this is the person you meet, yeah. Oh, this looks like kuntilanak, yeah. Sorry, but I say it's wrong. Yeah, this is a person you meet. The distance here is 10 meter. The question is, yeah, the total distance traveled. I am sure if you meet kuntilanak, you will not be able to calculate because you will run away. Yeah. Okay. Okay. Yeah. Okay. If some of you meet kuntilanak, I don't. My friend, yeah, he wants to pass the final exam. Of his bachelor thesis, before he go to the day of the bachelor thesis exam, the lecturer says before you can present your presentation, you have to repeat your results because your results are not so satisfactory. Yeah, ayo ulangi percobaanmu. Your results are not satisfactory. Do it again. And he only have one night, one day time. And so he went to the IPP lab in Baranang Siang. You know, this is this old building, and he do the experiment alone. And this is, you know, this is a scary place. Why? Because actually there is a legend there that when you go to the lab after 4 p.m., some scary things happen. For example, you hear voices like this. Yeah. Or you hear some voice like, yeah. So something like that. And then things started to move. Yeah. For example, yeah, you find in the lab, yeah, things started to move. Like this. This is also scary because you cannot see the object. This is actually bawang goreng, yeah, bawang goreng. So, started to move by itself. Yeah, this bawang goreng. Yeah, I don't know what kind of experiment in the lab is doing bawang goreng. So, and then something start to move. Yeah, suddenly there is a mouse. Yeah, mouse moving. Yeah, not like this, but a real mouse moving. And then my friend is alone in the lab. And then he heard at night some strange voices. Yeah. And normal people will get afraid, but he only have one day left. When he left the building, then he cannot do the final exam and he will not be graduated from IPP at the right time. He will disappoint his girlfriend, yeah, and his parents, for example. Yeah. And so you know what he did? He said to the ghost, yeah. I say in Indonesia, yeah. Weh setan jangan ganggu gua, dosen gua lebih setan weh. That's what he said. That's what he said to the ghost. And then suddenly the stop, yeah. Because the ghost is afraid, yeah. Because the lecturer is more setan than the ghost. This is yeah. It means that and he passed with very good marks, yeah. And say the friends and I congratulate him, yeah. His name is Sigit, yeah. Sigit, congratulations on your graduation, yeah. Yeah, I say you don't know what I have to do. I have to fight against Kuntil Anak and Gendruwo, you know. Okay, so you are lucky if you are not meeting a ghost. Okay, so what I'm not teaching you, I'm like a comic, yeah, not like a lecture. Okay. So the distance is the total path. You go from here to Kuntilanak is 50 meters. You go back to this point plus 10 meters is 60 meters. But the displacement is the initial and the final is only 40 meters. Yeah. So when you go back from Kuntilanak back to the initial place, the total distance is 120 meters. The total displacement is zero when you go back to your initial place. Yeah. And then this is the okay. So actually we only have half an hour left. Don't problem. I can do all the lecture in 5 minutes. Yeah. So what when Pak Dodi give lecture, yeah, 10-minute lecture, 120-minute jokes. Sorry. Yeah. So the average speed, distance traveled divided by elapsed time. You know this person? This is Hussein Bolt. Yeah. Not the dog in the Disney story. Yeah. This is another Bolt. Yeah. This is Hussein Bolt, the fastest man in the world. Yeah. If you want to steal some from a pocket, don't steal from his pocket. Yeah, you cannot run away from him. Yeah. Okay. So the world record for 100 meter is 9.58. Yeah. The world record for Pak Dodi running 100 meter is 30 seconds, something like that. Yeah. Far from Sanford. Yeah. Okay. So you can see, yeah, that to calculate, yeah, the average speed is the total distance divided by the elapsed time. This is rata-rata, yeah, the average speed. Why do we need average speed? Because we only concern about the distance or the total distance, yeah, or the average velocity. If a car travels 200 meters in 10 seconds, we say its average speed is 20 meters per second. This is simply 200 divided by 10. Yeah. What is Bolt's average speed? Yeah, it's easy. Average speed is just 100 divided by 9.58. So it's like 10 meters per second. You can imagine 10 meters per second. Yeah. How do you converse meter per seconds to kilometer per hour? Okay, I tell you this one. Meter per second. How much is 1 meter to 1 kilometer? Okay, let's say 1 kilometer per 1 hour. 1 kilometer. How many meter? You know? Can you give me a hint? How 1 kilometer is how many meters? 1,000. 1 hour is how many seconds? 3,600. So, from meter per seconds to kilometer per hour, you just put a comma here. So, 1 meter per second is equal to 3.6 kilometer per hour, right? Yeah. So if Usain Bolt, for example, has a speed of 10 meter per second, how many kilometer per hour is this? 36 kilometer per hour, just normal like this. Yeah. If your car runs with 72 kilometer per hour, how many meter per second is this? Just divide by 3.6. This is equal to 20 meter per second. So this is easy. You can convert from meter to second to kilometer per hour using the formula 3.6. Yeah. Okay, just clear this. Let's go. The average velocity is just that the distance divided by the time. Yeah. Yeah. Now, be careful. Velocity is a vector. So you have to consider this is as displacement. Yeah. Consider this is the displacement is this. Sorry. This is the displacement. This is the average velocity vector, yeah. So it's not the average velocity, the displacement is zero. The average velocity is zero. The speed is scalar, yeah. Velocity is vector. Okay. If the time from previous problem, for example, if the time needed to move from x1 to x2 is 10 seconds, yeah, just calculate 40 divided by 10. In this case, yeah, it's 4 meters per second. This is easy. Okay. Oh, this is another problem. Yeah. If the displacement proof in the points in the positive direction, the average velocity is also positive. This is just a matter of convention, yeah. Okay. So you can see here, yeah. The displacement points in the negative direction, the average velocity is negative. Positive and negative is just a matter of convention atau perjanjian. To the right is positive, to the left is negative. Actually, the law of physics don't care about positive and negative. So this is just to tell you that they are moving to the right or to the left. This is just to give you more information. There is nothing special about positive and negative. Yeah? Because the law of physics is the same. It doesn't care about your position. Yeah? It doesn't care about the change of coordinate. It's just a matter of convention. 1 kilometer per hour. This I already tell you. Just multiply, just divide it by 3.6. Divide this number by 3.6, okay? So you get 0.278. Well, acceleration is the change in the velocity. The velocity is the change in the displacement. So we have displacement. We have the velocity and we have the what? We have the acceleration. Yeah. Acceleration is just under this. Acceleration is the derivative. Okay. So this is just a displacement, velocity, acceleration. Yeah. Okay, this is this easy to remember. Yeah. They have the same formula actually. The difference is just not the displacement, is replaced by the velocity. Yeah. And this is actually a factor, so you don't have, you have to put a factor here. Yeah. The slide maker is not me, so maybe he feel in hurry. Yeah, but I'm not angry of the slide maker, because of his duty, I don't have to make the slides. So lazy. Yeah, no, it's okay. So don't forget. Put a factor sign. If the factor sign is on the left, it must be on the right. The left side factor, then on the right side must also be a factor. Yeah, remember, factor, factor, scalar, scalar, factor, scalar. This is wrong. When you have factor on the left, you must have factor on the right. Yeah. For example, you have gravity. This is the formula of gravity. Force is a factor. Where is the factor here? This formula is not correct. You have to put a unit factor here. The unit factor, what is the unit factor? The unit factor is just a factor of one unit. Yeah, and it has no magnitude, just one magnitude. So magnitude is one. Yeah, so this is the correct way to draw the formula. Yeah, use this unit factor here. Okay. So when you have factor on the left, there must be factor on the right. So this is the factor. Yeah, factor, factor. This is correct. Yeah. I make many jokes, but in mathematics, I have to be a little serious because mathematics is the language of physics. Don't play with mathematics. Okay. I mean, enjoy mathematics, but we have to be precise in mathematics. Okay. Oh, I think this is the car of Pavin Kumar. Yeah, and you see Venom GT. I think Pavin, you can 120 meter per second, kilometer per second. Yeah. Okay. And this is also Teddy Latifatul Asia's car is Bugatti Veyron, yeah. Right. Okay. So top speed 434.5 kilometer per hour. Accelerates from 0 to 97 kilometer per hour in 2.7 seconds. What is the acceleration? Yeah. You can find this. Yeah. What is known? Top speed, velocity is 434. Yeah. Accelerates from 0 to 97 kilometer per hour. So what we have this one? Delta V, right? Delta V is 97, so we don't use this. Divided by, what is the time? 2.7. 97 divided by 2.97, this is the answer. Delta T, this is the acceleration. So acceleration is delta V divided by delta T. Yeah? Delta V divided by delta T, this is the acceleration. So you can do number two. It's just hundreds divided by, be careful. This is kilometer per hour. Oh, be careful. I make a mistake. You have to divide this first into meter per second. Yeah. Divided this first by 3.6. This is my mistake. divided these two. Then you have meter per seconds. You have to be careful because there is information in seconds. Otherwise, the time you have to change into hour. Yeah. So, number two, accelerate 100 from zero. Be careful. This is kilometer per hour. You have to make meter per seconds. Divide first by 3.6. After that, divided by 2.5. And this is then the correct answer. Yeah. So remember, if your velocity is in kilometer per hour and your time is in seconds, then change the velocity to meter per second first. Calculation. This is dimensional consistency. Dimensional consistency. Yeah, don't forget. Deceleration, yeah, is the opposite of acceleration. Yeah, for example, the parachute. Remember, the acceleration and the plane, and then you use parachute. You fall down, but actually your force is upward. Your acceleration is upwards. Yeah, it's called a deceleration. And you can use the same formula. So you can apply. Yeah, when does the object stop after several times? So, suppose the plane in figure 2 to 4 starts from rest. Yeah. When t is 0, the plane accelerates. Okay. Why can a plane fly? Actually, the main reason a plane can fly is because of the velocity. Yeah. Not of the wings, but more of the velocity. Because a plane, it must have a final acceleration that is possible only if the plane can run sufficient long distance. And after reaching this velocity, then the wings are important. But before that, it must reach a certain velocity. So number one cause of the plane can fly is the velocity. Bernoulli's law is the wings, yeah, which stated that the velocity of the wings above and below is different, so there is a drag force that goes upward. But the first reason that a plane can fly is the velocity, yeah? And the third reason is the Coanda effect. The Coanda effect is that air when flow through the wings, it will follow the same Coanda is the reason a plane can fly. Not as stated in your high school books, the plane can fly because of the Bernoulli principle. This is only one from three. Actually, there are three reasons why a plane can fly. Yeah. So that plane accelerates down from the runway and t29 times velocity of the plane. Average acceleration is simply vector delta vector divided by delta t. Yeah. What is delta velocity? Delta velocity from zero, right? Okay. So 260. Remember, 260 is not meter divided by 3.6. You divide by 29. Okay. Yeah. Actually, I need calculator here. Divided by the total time, 29 seconds, So the answer is 2.4 meter per second square. Yeah, 2.5 meter per second square. Yeah, this is the average acceleration. So using this formula, we can also write and obtain this formula. This is very simple, yeah. Look, the formula V is equal to delta X divided by delta T. So delta X is equal to V times delta T, yeah, is equal to X minus X zero is equal to V times delta T. So X is equal to X zero plus V times delta T. And if X zero is zero, then we have simply have X is equal to V times delta T, or T zero is zero, then we have X is equal to V times T. And if we obtain the formula of X is equal to V property just by the definition, from the definition of the average velocity, we can obtain the simple formula. Yeah. Just do the simple calculation. Yeah. Just from the definition. It's very simple. Definition, and then you explore. Yeah, you can just repeat my lecture after this. So this is the graphical representation. If there is zero acceleration, then the points will be always in the same distance. Sorry. The same distance. Yeah. So these are the same distance. Okay. This is same, this is the same, this is the same, this is the same. Two, for example, 2 meters, 2 meters, 2 meters, 2 meters. Measure every second. 1 second, 2 second, 3 second. This is what you do in the lab. 5 seconds. So this means velocity 2 meter per seconds. Simple. Yeah. So 2 meter per seconds, for example. Then the position will be flat. Not flat, but just increase gradually in a straight line. Sorry, yeah. Velocity constant, for example, like this. Acceleration is zero. Yeah, the graph will be just like this. Motion with constant acceleration, we then have definition A is equal to V minus V zero divided by T minus V zero. Put this here, we have V minus V zero is equal to AT minus AT zero. And if T zero is zero, if T zero is defined in the first second zero, then we have V is equal to V zero plus AT. Yeah, this is the formula for constant acceleration. Simple from the definition. Yeah, from the definition. Yeah, for me it's simple. For you maybe not. I'm sorry. Okay, but this is just from the definition. For constant acceleration, you can put the formula here, and you will obtain this formula. What I wanna teach you is just don't remember the formula. What do you have to remember? What you have to remember is, for example, the number of the size of the shoe of your boyfriend or girlfriend. Yeah, because when they have birthday, you have to understand, you know, the size. Yeah, so physics formula. Yeah, I give you this. Physics formula should be derived, not memorized. Physics formula should be derived. To be able to derive, you have to understand the concepts. Yeah? What else? To be able to understand concepts, you have to be open-minded. Yeah, to be open-minded is you have to be open-minded and truly want to know physics. What is the motivation? Make physics a fun thing for you. Okay. A fun thing for you. Understand that physics is about nature, not about memorizing. Yeah. So please remember my words here. It should be memorized. Yeah.
Yeah.
Adira, the mistake in education of physics is to force memorize, not to make it fun. Yeah? To force memorizing and make it fun. This is the mistake. Yeah? Because you know the concepts, you can derive hundreds of them. Okay. This is the important. Okay, we don't have much time. Yeah. But for accelerated motion, you see the starts like this. The distance is growing and growing. So you have at each seconds, yeah, first seconds, 2 seconds, 3 seconds, and so on. Yeah. This is a constant acceleration. So the graph will be the graph will be just like this. The graph will be position increases, but it increases in the sense of parabolic. Yeah? The increasement is parabolic, not linear. Yeah, not linear but parabolic. The velocity increases linearly. Yeah, this is parabolic. The acceleration is constant. Yeah. We call this constant acceleration. The velocity linear, acceleration just a line, and this is parabolic. Yeah, parabolic is like x square, like something like that. Because it x is equal to half a t square. So you have this square here. Yeah. The square here is parabolic, t square, parabolic, clear. Huh? Decelerated motion is like this. You start with huge distance, but then the distance gets smaller and smaller. Yeah, 1 second, 2 second, 3 second, 4, this is decelerated. Like when you drive the car and you brake the car. So the position will be like this. Yeah? Position will be this, declining. Velocity will go down. Acceleration is negative. Yeah? This is decelerated motion. So I have this kind of feature here. Yeah? Okay. So this is the problems that you can solve. Bicyclist maintains constant velocity with the outgoing blah blah blah. Corresponding time. Using the time and position interval indicate the drawing. Obtain the velocities. Yeah, the velocities is easy to obtain from this drawing. Just look at the gradient. The velocity is the gradient, meaning. Velocity is the distance divided by the time. This is the slope of this time. So 400 divided by 200 is 2. Yeah, here the velocity is constant because there is no delta x. It's 0. Velocity is 0 here. And here we have the deceleration. This is acceleration and we have deceleration. We have negative, yeah? Because we have here minus 400 divided by by 400. This is 1. Yeah, this is acceleration 2, deceleration 1, and this in the middle is 0. It's not so hard. Yeah, this is simple motion atau gerak lurus beraturan. Yeah, we can do this. Yes, not so hard. We have another problem here. This is how you solve the problem. Yeah, just what I told you. Also, this is a constant acceleration. For example, gerak jatuh bebas, ya, free fall. You have just one acceleration is the gravity here. The only acceleration is the gravity. The gravity is pointing downwards, so you have to give a minus sign here. Yeah. The formula is V0 minus gravity times T, because V0 plus AT plus AT is now replaced by minus GT. It's not so hard. Yeah. You can calculate this. So up with an initial speed of 5 meters per second, how high does the coin above it points off? So this is the case of tossing a coin, and the coin will go up and the coin will go back again. You know this formula is V is equal V0 plus AT. When will it reach the final height? And the final height is the final velocity is 0, right? Because it will stop here. So you have the 0 is equal to 5 minus 10. This is the number of gravity times T. Yeah. Yeah, just calculate the time first. So 10 is equal to 5. So T is equal to half. Yeah. So the height reach will be X is equal to setengah AT kuadrat. Yeah. Half times A. A is 10. The time is half squared. Yeah. So we have 5 times 1 per 4. So the distance will be 5 per 4 meters or 1.25 meters. This is the thing. What you have to understand is that the final velocity is 0 in when they turn around, the final velocity is 0, so you put 0 here. Put 0 here. Okay. So there are other problems. Oh, 0.25. Yeah. So this is gonna 25. Airplane take off problem. We can solve this using the formula here. Yeah. Plane landing you can also solve. Please read this first. Yeah. I will not teach you this here because it's from your homework. To study the two problems here. Yeah. Study the two problems here. So by that, actually, yeah, the lecture is closed. So now I want to hear your opinion. This is more exciting for me because I'm getting bored. Yeah, I'm getting okay. Okay. Samira John. Hello, Samira. Are you with me, Samira?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. What do you think about this lecture? Please feel free to criticize me. I don't care about what if you do criticize me. Just tell you what's your opinion about this lecture so I can improve in the future.
I think it's quite good, sir, because you try and make it fun with all the jokes and all, so it's not just a boring lecture. Okay. Nice.
So maybe for the next meeting, every one of you can find the funniest background and put it on the screen so we can enjoy the lecture more. So like for example, you have some funny things that you can use as background, you can use it for your lecture, okay?
Okay.
So, okay, now I wanna hear from Satria Tegar, my favorite. Satria.
Yes, sir.
Are you awake?
Yep.
Okay. So I'm just joking. I mean, of course. What is your opinion about today's lecture?
Maybe same with Samira John, sir. It was fun. I think especially when you said your joke was not funny, but it's actually funny, sir.
Yeah, because when I say it's not funny, then you feel pity for me, yeah? Okay. So the funny thing is because I'm not funny or because it's actually funny?
It's actually funny, sir.
Oh, that's very good for you. I hope that you are sincere. Okay. Okay, so now anyone who wants to give comments, please, you can just turn on the audio and just tell me what you think about this lecture. Anyone, just speak up. Don't feel afraid, okay? Anyone want to give comments? This is a good, I like this. Sometimes the smartest person is the craziest, yeah? So let's all be crazy, yeah? Okay. You know, crazy is sometimes creative and innovative. Yeah. Okay, one more person for you for opinion. Maybe I wanna ask Miss Kong Kawai. Hello, can you turn on your speaker? So hello. So what do you think about this lecture? You can give us a negative comment, don't worry.
I really like your teaching method, sir.
Okay. So it's more like relaxed, yeah. So sometimes yes. With jokes, yeah. Because you know physics is actually more enjoyable if you are not under stress, yeah. So just try to understand, right? So okay. So is there any critics, like if I speak too fast or something like that? Or...
No, sir. So far so good.
Okay, thank you. Okay, one more then. Surya Kumaren. Surya?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. What do you think about the lecture today?
I feel it's good, sir, but it's just that sometimes the background noise is a bit disturbing, sir.
Okay.
Yeah. So
can you give any suggestion how to maybe I can find a place where it's not so noisy, right?
Okay. With kids, normally we cannot help it, sir. So I understand the situation, sir.
Okay. Sorry. So. Okay. Yeah. Thank you for your comments. One more maybe. Ya Farah lah, Farah Nabila. Ya. Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, what's your opinion about this lecture?
So far so good lah, sir. I can understand what you're trying to teach us.
Okay. What is the difference between your lecture in high school and university? It's actually the same subject, right? But do you see the differences in this lecture?
Yeah, like the title is different from high school.
Mm-hmm. School title. Okay, but you say that you don't feel too afraid with the lecture anymore, right? Because it's more more fun, right? Is it true?
Yeah, I don't think I'm afraid to study physics because it's fun.
Okay, that's nice. Okay, the last one maybe I wanna ask Muhammad Ra. Who is this? Muhammad Rai. Muhammad Raihan or what? Who is Muhammad? Ramadan. Ah, okay. What do you say about this lecture?
I think it's really exciting, sir. Studying with you because it's more fun.
Okay. So I'm happy to hear this. So maybe your opinion, what is the funniest joke that I give today?
Yeah.
You can tell me what's the funniest joke.
The funniest, I think it's all funny. All funny. Okay. I can stop laughing.
Good. So this means that my my project for today is complete, accomplished. Yeah, mission accomplished. Because I can make you laugh. Yeah. You know, please don't be afraid of this lecture. Yeah. Please make this lecture something that you wait for. Because why is my background changing? Because you have to enjoy it. Yeah, you have to enjoy this lecture. Okay, so if there is no more question, I thank you for your attention. Please don't forget that the quiz is after 3 lessons. Yeah, so don't do any homework unless you don't have anything else to do. There is no homework after 3, only after 3 lectures. Okay, thank you. Also, for your next lecture, you can also use animation for your background. Yeah, for example, you can use this kind of things. Yeah, okay. So don't feel afraid. I want you to express yourself. Yeah, so you can do any expression. The only thing that is forbidden is not to wear clothes. Yeah, please wear your clothes. Okay, this is the only instruction. Yeah. Actually, I don't agree that the university has too many rules. Yeah, the only rule in the university is not to disturb with politics. That's the only rule. Whatever you do in university, actually you can do what you like because university is a place of creativity. Yeah. So in this lecture, in my lecture, you are free to express yourself. Whatever background you use, you can use animation. You can. Why do I encourage you to do this? First is you have to enjoy this lecture. Second, you can make your friends laugh. You can make your friends laugh. Your friends feel happy. And then what they do, they will forget everything. No, they will be more able to sleep. No, but be more able to enjoy this lecture. Okay. So thank you for your participation. I'm happy that you enjoy this lecture. My next duty is to make you more confident about physics. Yeah. First target for today is to make you feel happy about this lecture. I hope my mission is accomplished. I want to make you feel happy about this lecture. Second objective next week, I want you to make comfortable with the physics. Yeah. Comfortable is you know the concepts, but you don't feel stressed. Just enjoy the concepts. Okay. Okay. Thank you for your attention. And I want to say good afternoon and see you next week. Tomorrow we have practicum, right? At the time.
Yes, sir. Friday, sir.
Oh, Friday. So Friday morning, right? Friday morning. Last week we have holiday, so next Friday will be the first, and I will give a short introduction. And practicum is actually can be enjoyable, yeah. And please remember that if you have any question, don't hesitate to ask. Yeah. Thank you for your attention. Have a nice day. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.
Thank you, sir. Have a nice day.
Thank you, sir.
Very, very good afternoon to you all. Enjoy your holiday. Yeah.
You too, sir.
Enjoy your holiday. I think every day is holiday. Okay. Bye bye. Bye bye.